People once believed that when someone dies, a crow carries their soul to the land of the dead. But sometimes, something so bad happens that a terrible sadness is carried with it and the soul can't rest. Then sometimes, just sometimes, the crow can bring that soul back to put the wrong things right.
Listen, I said it was the year of content. I never said it was the year of good content. Some weeks I'm just gonna be performing scenes from The Crow. A classic. Most of you have probably heard of elephant mourning, or the tender way that chimpanzees seem to react to their dead. But have you heard of a crow funeral?
Here lies Reginald. He died the way he lived, eating Burger King from a trash can.
I mean, it seems obvious, right? Of course those harbingers of death would have funerals. Technically, funeral is a bit of a misnomer here. We're always trying to anthropomorphize animals. Really, what we're talking about is more akin to a crow postmortem investigation. Throughout 2013 to 2014, researchers at the University of Washington undertook an animal behavioral study that may have seemed more than a little creepy to the casual outside observer. Researchers would descend on Seattle area crow hotspots wearing these neutral masks, which can only remind you of the Texas Chainsaw Massacre, and wearing signs around their necks that said, UW Crow Study. They would come wearing these masks and brought with them, among other things, cheese puffs and dead birds. So basically, my Saturday night. Imagine that you're enjoying a peaceful stroll through a verdant Mercer Island park. All of a sudden, you come upon Leatherface, slowly turning in a circle, a taxidermied animal in his outstretched palm. A pile of cheese puffs sits nearby, and a group, congregation, murder of crows, is dive-bombing the Leatherface, shrieking, making noise, all around generally freaking out. As bizarre as that sounds, that's what this experiment really looked like. At this point, you're probably wondering why the volunteers had to wear those creepy neutral masks. The researchers didn't want the crows to learn to associate specific human faces with specific threats. Crows are smart. They'll remember your jerk face for years, and they'll tell their crow friends about it too. One of the researchers, Kaylee Swift, told the New York Times that even though she reassured onlookers, "This is for science," they were still like, "I don't care. I'm calling the police," which, sort of fair. But, nervous Seattleites aside, they learned a lot about how crows regard their dead. They would present their crow groups with stimuli, like dead crows and dead pigeons. They found that when live crows would see the dead crows, they would mob the researchers, crying out, trying to get to their dead, and they did this almost every time. But crows shown a dead pigeon didn't seem all that interested. They never mobbed the researchers and only cried out about 40% of the time. When the researchers didn't have any dead bird at all, the crows didn't do anything abnormal. They were just like, "Oh, hey." Pigeons, by the way, didn't give a crap about pigeon corpses. Assholes of the bird world. What this all amounts to is that crows seem to see their dead as something they can learn from. By surrounding a dead crow, they can maybe see why it died, if there's any imminent danger, and what they can do to protect themselves from that danger. So yes, crows care about their dead, but only in so much as it helps them stay alive. This all may seem a bit cold and utilitarian, especially given what we've heard about elephants gently stroking the bones of their fallen comrades. But given how intelligent crows are, is them surrounding a dead crow really all that different than medical students surrounding a cadaver or a coroner performing an autopsy? And there I go anthropomorphizing. Practice what you preach, Caitlin. Can I get a little Photoshop of a crow coroner here? Great, that's perfect. Thanks, bye. So the next time you're jogging through a park, I won't be doing that, but you might be a jogger, I don't know. And you see a crow struck dead. Do not recoil, but believe that that crow may have helped his compatriots live another day. Do you have any stories about an animal reacting to death? If so, did you tend to see it through a human lens, like, oh, they're feeling grief? Let me know in the comments. Year of Content. Brought to you with support from People's Memorial Association and the Co-op Funeral Home, and donations from viewers like you.
It's more like surfing than skating. I wish it would stop just once.
It can't rain all the time.
Eric? Yes, it can. It can rain all the time. It's raining all the time.
Year of Content.